Hey y'all, it's science time. Are you ready? Boom! Guess what we're gonna do today? We're gonna build a bridge. A bridge. That is right, a bridge. So today, I'm gonna read you a challenge. It's called Build a Bridge. So let's look at the problem here. I'm gonna change the names on this and try to make it funny. Now, I'm not trying to make anybody feel bad. I'm just trying to be funny. So don't get mad. So there are three kids. We're gonna call them Johnny, Billy, and Hannah. And you know what? They want to go up to a hillside to eat this awesome candy that's at the top of it. It's like there's this candy store, and it's like, hey kids, come get some candy because this is the best candy for you. It makes you smart, it makes you funny, it makes you try hard, everything that anybody could ever want. But they have to cross this bridge to get there. And under the bridge lives this mean troll. We'll call her Mrs. Fiffner. And she lives there. And she doesn't want these kids getting that candy. No, she doesn't. But we do. We want you to get this candy because it'll make you better. So how are we going to do that? How are we going to build a bridge to get across this divide to get to the mountain of candy? Let's find out. All right, so what you're first going to do is you're going to take a look on your iPad or your computer or your phone or outside at bridges. Find as many as you can. Be like, oh, hey, look at that bridge. It's so pretty. Oh, hey, look at that bridge. Thing you need to do after looking at bridges is think of what type of bridge you're going to do. Now, we did a project like this in Mr. Ackerson's class with bridges, but you're going to have to draw a picture first. Show me your rough sketch. Sketch out your bridge first, because remember, drawing it will help you build it. And if you can build it, or if you can draw it, you'll be able to build it later on. So this is a blueprint. Make sure that you draw your bridge first. Now, we're going to ask you to take pictures of this drawing or video of all the steps at the end. So make sure this picture is in your final draft. Go get all your materials. Make sure you have all that stuff because it is time to build that bridge. Build that bridge. Make it strong. Now, I want this bridge to cover about 12 inches. That's about this far. Your bridge needs to cover 12 inches. And imagine that this is actually a 120-foot bridge, but we're going to scale it down to 12 inches. You need to make a bridge that can span 12 inches, and it has to be strong. So 12 inches right there, and it's got to go all the way across, and it's got to be strong. How are you going to support it? Because remember, under that bridge is mean Mrs. Fiffner. Rah! She's going to eat you. Rah! Don't let her eat you. Don't let her eat you. Get your supplies and build that bridge. When you're done, I want pictures and videos of your bridge because it's going to be awesome. Did your bridge stand up all alone on the first try, the second try, third try? Now, do you think that the kids can safely get across this bridge? Now, what we're going to do is you need to go and you need to raid your sister's or your brother's or your mom's Barbie collection or G.I. Joe or action figures or Marvel X-Men or whatever, and I need you to find three little figurines, or you know, they could be big too. Barbies are kind of big because they're going to be our fake people. They're going to be our three kids trying to get across that bridge so Mrs. Fiffner doesn't get them. Ah! So get those three things, and we're going to see if those three figurines, those three dolls, can sit on your bridge without it collapsing.
Right.
Did it work? I don't know. I'm not there. You're going to have to show me. So take a picture. Take videos. I think videos are the best. Send those to me. I had a couple of videos of the Build It Challenge with the box. Some kids made some awesome things. Sid made a marble roller coaster-like thing, which is funny because we're going to do a project like that later. But then Gracie made a box that had wheels on the bottom, and it was awesome. It's great seeing the creativity from you guys. So take videos. Explain your thinking. Be like, hey, Mr. Ray. Hey, Ms. Skeech. This is why I did this. Because I think that this makes things stronger. We want to hear about it. Post it on our Google Classroom challenge. But remember, you have questions to answer in the Google Classroom link after this. So make sure you get those questions answered. Make sure you get those questions answered for us so that we can respond to it. Be creative. Be descriptive. Tell us everything. And have fun.